Hi all, my name is Raj from RCE. Today we go to unbox M4 Plus Anycast dongle. Explain the difference from M2 Plus, Anycast and M4 Plus. And then we connect with our laptop and desktop wirelessly to the TV. We will touch base how to connect from mobile in our next video. So let us go and unbox first. So here is the M4 Plus. If you see the box, it is written no need to mode switch. So this is the only difference between Anycast, M2 Plus and M4 Plus. So M4 Plus automatically switch over between Miracast mode to DLNA and AirPlay mode as you connect from your mobile phone and from laptop or desktop. No need to switch over with the small button which is available in Anycast dongle. So M4 Plus box contain one M4 Plus dongle, which looks very much similar to M2 Plus or Anycast. Small switch available in M4 Plus also, but it is of no use. I mean, it is not required to be used. Software automatically detects whether we are in Miracast mode or we are in DLNA or AirPlay mode. There would be a power cable. One side we need to connect to USB port. You may have additional USB port in your TV, or if you don't have, then you need to connect to any of the power adapter and power switch. Other side we have USB micro USB to connect on dongle. This is the Wi-Fi antenna. So let us connect. We connected the dongle. Let me connect the power. Connected the power. If you see that dongle is showing blue color light, it means that it is switched on. And behind the TV, you need to connect to HDMI port. So I have a small HDMI extension wire to connect, and I'm connecting with that dongle. So now if you see that, there is a main screen. On top, you will see all three things together. SSID, which is nothing but a dongle ID, a password and IP address. And at the middle, if you see DLNA/AirPlay/Miracast, it means that it automatically detects based on your connection. Now let us go ahead and connect from our laptop Windows 10 operating system or desktop Windows 10 operating system. You go in the desktop, anywhere, right click on the screen, second last option called display setting, click on that. A pop-up window will open, click on display and then scroll down a little bit. You may see multiple display and below connect to a wireless display. Click on that. A pop-up window will open. Search. You may search the dongle SSID. So after doing one or two time, you will see a dongle ID. Anycast E009EC, which is nothing but a dongle SSID, if you see on the screen. Click on that. It shows connecting. Follow any instruction on your device and connect it. So these are the only steps which you need to connect your laptop or desktop wirelessly to your TV and play any of the video from online. Let me play YouTube. Any of the video which you feel that needs to be. See, TV plays exactly the same what is displaying in your desktop or laptop monitor. So this is from Windows 10. Here are the steps for Windows 10 laptop and desktop. Right click on your desktop display setting. Click on display. Scroll down, connect to wireless display. Here is the dongle SSID which we just walked through. Click and connect. See, it is already connected. Let us see what all steps it needs to connect your laptop and desktop to your TV. If your operating system is Windows 7 or Windows 8, 8.1. Go to your wireless, disconnect your home connection, and you may see that a dongle SSID is visible here. Connect. It will ask the password. You will see a monitor, TV screen, password next to your SSID, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, which may different based on your dongle. Click on yes. It may take few seconds to connect your wireless to dongle SSID. It won't show internet access. It say no internet because dongle doesn't have the internet access. Here it connects, no internet, secured, though it is connected. Now let us open Windows Media Player. Search any video from your playlist. When you play the video, at right top corner, switch to library. You will see that play option, burn and sync. Click on play. If there is no option written as play to device, then click on stream. Turn on media streaming. Click on OK. Now check all three options should be ticked and go back to play. Now you will see that play to and cast to device. Connection in progress, obtaining IP address, it is connected. So this is the way you can connect your Windows 7 or Windows 8 from desktop, laptop to your TV. We will run through the step directly through screen capture to showcase clearly what all steps we followed. Open your Wi-Fi network. Check SSID. Connect. Okay, disconnected, no internet secured. That's what you will see because dongle SSID does not have a direct internet connection. Now open a Windows Media Player. Play any video in your laptop or desktop. A
Hi all, my name is Raj from RCE. Today we go to review our
at right top corner you will see
watch.
Switch to library
K88 plus.
Click on play.
Or K88 plus.
You may see
this
that there is a tower kind of icon
which has the feature.
If it is not visible, go to stream.
Blood oxygen, heart rate monitoring.
Turn on media streaming.
Other fitness tracking features. And
turn on media streaming from
sleep
here.
Monitoring.
It is allowed. Click on OK.
So today we go to unbox.
Now if you go back again to play, you will
verify
see
which application need to be
play
installed.
Play to option.
Configure the
cast
application.
To device and dongle SSID.
If you have any queries, do write to us in our YouTube channel. We will try to address it as quickly as possible. Do subscribe us. We keep on preparing really good videos to help everyone. Thanks for today. Have a nice day.